Now we'll begin to take a look at the platform from an end user perspective, beginning with the web portal. Here within the web portal, you can see our existing branding and our custom URL, all of which can be changed to match your business's look, feel, and name. Next, we'll go ahead and log into the application. Before I start to interact with any files and storage, I want to briefly touch on the layout of the web portal in the post login dashboard before you. At the top, I get a brief overview about the number of files, storage quota, and shares that are applied to my user. To the left, I have my navigation, including network folders and shares. To the right-hand side, I have my activity feed for the site. This, like most everything you see in FileCloud, can be enabled or disabled within the admin panel to your preference. Lastly, in the middle, I can see some of my recent documents with various options I have to interact with them. Before I start interacting with any of the files, I want to briefly talk about our network, team, and user storage that you see before you. Beginning with my files, this is personal storage space that's been created by my FileCloud administrator and has been assigned to our current user. Right below this is team folders and there are network shares. Team folders are created by the FileCloud admin and can be shared with users or groups for ease of access. In my case, I have a sales group folder available to me with various sales materials. Network shares are existing network folders or cloud shares that your organization has and has access to. These can be across multiple systems or networks, but will appear here in one place with a name you assign. This helps with the problem of storage sprawl across multiple sites and clouds by giving the users a unified view in one place that you manage and control. Let's take a look at how users would be viewing, accessing, and modifying these files from the application. I'll begin by previewing a file directly from the platform. This particular file may be familiar. Object preview is great because users can quickly view the file through the browser without downloading the complete file to their machine. Users can then proceed to make edits, which will download the file and then re-upload it after all the changes are complete to the server, synchronizing it once more. Now, let's dig a bit deeper into an individual file and the options we have around it. With a file selected, I'm able to review information about activity or changes made to the file. Optionally, I can even review older versions of the file and restore them if necessary. Within the metadata tab, I can review existing metadata about the file, as well as optionally add my own custom metadata. This can be used to quickly tag files for retention, legal hold, or identification in reporting or search. With comments built into the platform, users can collaborate on files in one place. I can even tag users directly or even groups in the comments to notify and send alerts. This makes the process of communicating and sharing even easier. So, with what we've seen so far, how does this help your end users? Well, with a unified view of storage, end users don't have to search multiple locations for their files anymore. It's all presented under that one view, no matter where it may be. With the use of metadata and custom metadata, we can automate processes, automate holds, and implement different policies that are relevant to your organization, as well as doing things like common identification. Now that we've seen how you can simplify folder and storage sprawl for end users, let's explore how they can utilize FileCloud to securely share files and folders internally or externally, all while keeping yourself secure and using your own URLs. FileCloud hosted shares are highly customizable, but your administrators will still have the ability to set policies to best fit your organization's needs and security requirements. These policies can be as simple as setting a maximum share duration site-wide, or even focused in on preventing sharing of certain types of data, PII, credit card details, or other potentially sensitive information that your organization may identify. With this share, I'll begin by optionally editing the share URL. You'll notice that the domain is my own. No third-party or external URL here. In this case, I'll give the share a relevant name. Next, I can set the duration of the share. This can be set for as long or as short as necessary, and can be even go so far as to limit the number of downloads. Shares can be made available for both users or groups, and can be tuned on a per user or group basis to fit the requirements or your needs. In my case, I'll be giving full permissions to our share users and groups. Adding new users to a share is easy. We start by searching for the user and then click Save. If we need to add a user who doesn't already have an account on our platform, we can just as easily invite them from the same place. No need to go out or reach out to admins to create the account or navigate to a separate page to invite the user to the share. After the share is created, I can also track activity and access to the share right from the same view. This is fantastic for seeing who is accessing the file and from where. Of course, at any time, if I want to remove the share, I can do so with a click, making management easy. All of my existing shares are also available for me to review through the navigation pane on the left-hand side of the screen under the heading Shared by Me. Let's recap what we just saw. I went through the steps an end user would go through to create and share a file or folders with both internal and external users or groups right from the platform. We saw the customization available on the share, including the option to use your own domains and custom naming. Now users can share externally without having to go through some strange third-party link that doesn't match your brand. From start to finish, users stay in your ecosystem and your branding. Finally, I showed the options to review share activity and delete the share if necessary.